Hello, welcome to Android Application Development Tutorials. This is a series of tutorials. In this tutorial lessons, we will be starting from small applications to larger applications. Please follow all the lessons and try it out. In this video, we will be seeing how to develop an application in which we can use checkboxes. Start a new Android. Choose a project name. Click Next. Choose the target. Next. Choose the package name. Rename the activity to main if you like to. Finish. You can view your project from the Package Explorer. Open the main.xml and main.java. In the main.xml, by default there is a text view, we don't want it. We can choose an application here. Which is using both set of radio buttons. These radio buttons we can rename as coffee. And T. Default both be unset. And we can have checkboxes. Checkbox. And we can name it as this, and we can go for one checkbox. We can name us cake, and we can have a button here, and the caption of the button, the text value of the button can be changed to order. And final aim of this project is user can click these items, and when they click on order, which are all the items ordered will be displayed. For displaying it, we need a view. We will choose a large text. The caption or the text, we can change this to the name of text view is text view 1, button is on 1. Checkboxes, checkbox 2 and checkbox 1, and radio 0 and radio 1 for the radio buttons. These are all the names of the components. These are required when we go for the Java file, when we write the codes. We have to declare the objects. First we will declare for button. Button, I am going to name it as button 1. We have two radio buttons. Radio button R1 comma R2. It is asking for import button class is imported. Similarly, we can go for the same thing for the checkbox C1 comma C2. And on create, we can initialize this object with the GUI component. C1 equal to find view by ID R dot ID dot button 1. we can go for a typecast. Button 1 is done. Similarly, R1, radio button 1, R1 equal to find view by ID, R.id. It is radio 0, semicolon, and you can go for typecast. Copy it, paste it, and rename to button 2, and it is radio 1. Similarly, for check 1, C1 equal to find view by ID, R.id. Checkbox 1, semicolon, typecast. Copy the thing, paste it, and we have C2, and here it is checkbox 2. All the objects are created and initialized, but we need one thing more, that is our text view. We can name it as TV1. TV1 equal to find view by ID, R.id. It is text view 1. Semicolon here. Typecast. Done. Now we have to give the functionality for the button. When the button is called, the item selected that will be displayed on the text view. Implements onClick listener. You can use onClick listener implementation here. And it is asking for add unimplemented methods. Our method is ready here. OnClick. We can give our code here. So we have to check which one is selected by the user. We can have a string variable here. String. String is a class. String order equal to null. If R1 is checked, then we have to give order equal to first radio button is for coffee. Give a semicolon here. Copy paste. If R2 is checked, it is T. And if C1 is checked, checkbox 1 is checked, order equal to, we have to concatenate order plus equal to biscuit, and if C2 is selected, then the order will be cake. We can have a slash n for a line split so that the next item will be in the next line. Save it. I think it is done. We will try the program. Save and run as an Android application. This is our GUI. We can choose tea or coffee. We can choose only one item. We cannot choose both tea and coffee. So choose coffee, and we can choose biscuit and cake. We can choose neither or both. Anyway, you can choose, but only coffee or tea. Both will not be able to select. And click on order. Nothing happened. Reason is very simple. We have done everything and we haven't displayed it on the text view. TV1.setText. We can set the order. Order is a string variable which is having all the values. Save it. Now run it. It is loaded. We can choose coffee or tea. We can choose biscuits, cake, or only cake, or none, anything. And we click on order. Still something is wrong. Okay. We should have given the click functionality enabled for the button one, because we are using implemented onClick listener style for implementing click listener for the button. So we have to do b1 dot set onClick listener this. Save it. Save the application and run it. We can choose coffee or tea. We can choose biscuit, cake, or both. Click order. This is our order: coffee, biscuit, cake. If I choose tea and place the order, tea, biscuit, cake. Tea and cake, tea and biscuit. This way, whichever items are selected, that items can be taken when the button order is clicked. So here there were serious mistakes when I was doing the code. First of all, B1 was not enabled for the click listening. So we have to set it on click listener this. This is the reference for this class main. And when it is clicked, that time, this will call onClick method, and onClick method will be implementing everything. So it is always better to be consistent with only one style of using listener. When we switch between different styles, this confusion may occur. Sorry for the trouble. And I hope you understood this program. We have used both radio buttons and checkboxes. Radio buttons are used only for opting one. Checkboxes, you can choose either or neither or both, and the values are read when a button is clicked. Thank you for watching this video. If you like the video, please don't forget to click like. Please subscribe the channel. I'll be uploading more videos, and please post your valuable comments on the channel page. Wish you a wonderful and successful day. Bye.